Attention, the following video is going to totally kick ass. If you enjoy any of it and or have a large penis, please click the like button below. Enjoy.
Life's good, I wouldn't have it another way. I might move, but believe I wouldn't run away. I ain't taking them all, I'm taking the closest. We're moving.
What's going on, guys? I'm Joel or Nobody Epic, and this is Awkward Situations, the series where you guys write your real life honest awkward situations in the comment section of this video. And then for the next episode of Awkward Situations, I'll take one or two of those comments, put them in a video, dissect them, tell you how and if they relate to my life, and then maybe there will be a little bit of advice at the end of the video, but I wouldn't bet on it because my advice is usually something that will get you killed or put in prison. So if you're here for the advice, you should leave and go pet a kitten or eat some chips and queso, because that's a Mexican delicacy I enjoy. I don't know if you guys indulge, you might be lactose intolerant, so you might not be able to do that. But if you're lactose intolerant, sometimes milk doesn't kill you. It just like makes your stomach hurt really bad and feels like you're getting stabbed, and then you're incapacitated. So I don't know. If you guys didn't know that about lactose intolerant people, now you know. If you didn't come for lactose intolerant facts, maybe I should start the episode Awkward Situations. Before I start, I will say that this is some Battlefield 4 open beta gameplay. I was going to put some GTA 5 gameplay in the background, but I realized I didn't have any saved and kind of in a time crunch, but I had some Battlefield 4 saved, so yeah, we're going to roll with that for now. And I love you and want to touch you inappropriately unless you're under the age of 18, in which Chris Hansen from Dateline NBC is going to come tap him. Oh, hi, Chris. Speaking of pedophiles, today's first awkward situation says, awkward situation. For a few months now, there's been this guy who has like 7 different phone numbers who's been trying to get me to jack off with him. He has graduated from high school and I'm only 15, so I think this is pedophilia. I want to tell someone, but I feel like everyone will think it's weird that I've let it go for such a long time. I'm really scared about the whole situation and I could really use someone to help me with it. Also, isn't the word for awkward spelled awkwardly? Well, first of all, I do agree that the word awkward is spelled awkwardly. It's frequently misspelled by me and people in the comments. But second of all, that's really weird that this guy calls you and he's like, hey, what are you doing today? You want to jack off or, you know, oh, you don't? All right, I'll call back tomorrow. And you said he has 7 different phone numbers, so that means he has like 7 different maybe cell phones. Maybe they're like those disposable phones you can buy at the store. What does he call you like, hey, it's the pizza delivery guy. I'm trying to deliver a pizza to your house. Did you want meat lovers with a side order of jacking off with me? Or no? Okay, yeah, it's me again. Sorry, bye. That's pretty crazy because I can kind of relate to that. Well, this is going to sound like you're going to be like, oh, sweet, you can relate to me, man. How do you help me with this problem? But I really can't. So we're going to try to make it work. But sometimes this army recruiter guy calls me and he tries to get me to join the army. But I'm like, fuck no, I don't want to join the fucking army and get shot by a gun and die. That's the fucking stupidest shit I've ever heard. But he calls me multiple times. He's been doing it since I was 18. So I have this number on my phone. And you guys probably have a couple of numbers like this that says do not answer. Or like mine says, what does mine say? I'm going to look at my phone. Mine says do not answer army recruiter dick. And I don't know if his name is Richard, but I think he's just a dick because he keeps calling me. I don't know how the fuck he got my number. And I've said do not call me before, but he's like, all right, I'll call back later. And I'm like, nope, fuck you. So I don't know. But at least he doesn't ask me to jack off of me. He's like, listen, I think you're going to be the best soldier ever. And one more thing, I was wondering if you wanted to jack off of me, you know, maybe touch my private or I'll touch your captain. Well, I'd probably have a private. He'd probably have a captain. Like, I don't know. But we won't get into gay military sex. But I'm at a loss for words because in terms of advice, I don't know if parents or counselors are prepared for some weird guy who is calling you about, you know, some serial masturbator who just wants a partner in crime. But you definitely do need to talk to someone. I would suggest a parent. I would be like, and this is actually kind of serious. This is kind of serious advice. I'd be like, Dad, there's this weird guy that keeps calling me, and it's really sexual. And if I was a dad and someone said that to me, and somebody was calling my kids sexually, I'd probably take a shotgun in their house and shoot them in the face. So that would solve your problem, but you don't want your dad to get arrested. So I think if you honestly just get up the courage to tell your parents that, because at least one time in your life, you're going to have to tell your parents something you don't want to. And think about this, guys. This is real. This is on some other level stuff. Well, not really. I mean, this is just real life advice. But there is going to be at least one time in your life where you have to get up courage to tell your parents something that you do not want to tell them. And I 100% guarantee you that they will not think it's as big of a deal as you do by telling them, because you get it all up in your head. And I'm like this too. I'm like an anxiety freak. You get it in your head that, you know, they're going to doubt you or they're going to be disappointed by you and all this stuff. But this isn't even your fault. And you could obviously explain the situation. It's not your fault. But you just have to get up the courage to be able to tell your parents this. And there's a lot worse things you could tell your parents that you don't want to tell them. Let me just give you a short list. You could tell them that you have syphilis, which is a sexually transmitted disease. That's really bad. You don't have to tell them that. You could tell them you got a girl pregnant, which also kind of sucks, unless you're like Mormon and that's cool. And you get girls pregnant like 22 times. No offense to Mormons. I mean, the joy of life, you know. You could have to tell your parents that you eat your peanut butter and jelly sandwiches with no crust on them. And you're like 22 and you do that. I do that. And I'm embarrassed. I'm sorry, I just said it. You know, sometimes I just don't like the crust. You know, fuck the crust. Let's get right to the meat and bones of it. And by meat and bones, I mean peanut butter and jelly, because I still eat those like every day. Because I guess I'm 7. I don't know. Or you could have to tell your parents that you're a guy that calls 15-year-olds because he needs a masturbating buddy. You know, that'd be a lot worse than being the 15-year-old who has to tell his parents that some fucking freakazoid is calling him saying, hey, it's, you know, me again. Maybe jack off today. I don't know. You know what they say on Twitter, jack off Thursdays, hashtag. But I don't know. Yeah, just get up that courage and tell your parents. Oh, well, you know, if I can relate to you, I had to get up the courage to tell my parents. I had I don't want to make it about me, but, you know, I had some mental issues like anxiety or something. And I eat my own fecal matter. No, that's fucked up. That's not true. Not all the time, but I, you know, I had some mental issues towards the end of high school, and I had to get some help for that. And it turns out I was scared to tell my parents about it and how I was feeling, all this stuff. But I told my parents about it, and my mom was like, "Yeah, a lot of people in our family have that. It runs in the family." And I was like, "Oh. Well, fuck. Let's get this fixed, I guess." It was just the biggest relief of my life, because I was scared to tell them for 3 or 4 months. I remember just being anxious about it and not being able to tell my parents about it, because they would think I was a failure or something in my head. I don't know, but it was stupid, because it runs in my family, like I said. So I don't know. I guarantee if you tell your parents, it won't be a big deal, and they'll get the problem solved, because that's what parents are supposed to do: solve your problems. Because you're just a little 15-year-old kid, you should be studying hard. And not have somebody studying you hard while masturbating. And yes, that's pedophilia. Since my episodes revolve around the topic of masturbation about once every 4 episodes, I think I will cap this off as a super masturbation episode with a second awkward situation that says, "Hey, nobody, I spent the night at a friend's over the summer. We went looking for his Black Ops 1, you know, to play some good old zombies. I was looking under his bed, throwing out water bottles and candy wrappers. Then I found a small hand towel crumpled and stuck together. I showed his to him, and he was like, 'What's that? Ha ha.' Me, of course, knowing his was a masturbation towel. I'm kind of scared to use any of his hand towels when I shower over there. What?" It's definitely never a good idea to touch anything a teenage boy has touched, because with raging hormones, at any given time, at least 85% of the time, they probably have semen on their hands. So if you're not into that, I would not touch anything that has previously made contact with their gross, jizz-covered hands. But this did remind me of some instances with friends or just things that are related to this. I remember one time I was at one of my close friends' house with a couple of guys, because I would spend the night with them or whatever, you know, sleepovers. And we were in his room, and he had a lot of Kleenexes around his bed and his ledge. And this was, we were 13 or something. This was around the time when you figure out that there's something more fun than your Game Boy and it's attached to your body. And he had a lot of Kleenexes around his bed, like I said. And I remember one of my friends saying, "Damn, man, you must get colds a lot. Because, you know, why would you have that many Kleenexes?" And he was like, "That's what my mom thinks." And it got a little awkward, you know. Because it was a joke, but then we kind of had to process it. And then we were like, oh, ew. So, That was kind of funny, looking back on it. And also, when I first learned that yogurt explodes out of your shaft, I remember wiping it on my bedpost, like my wooden bedpost, because I didn't think to, you know, use a Kleenex or a towel or swallow it or something. So it just, like, I did that for a good year or so. So my bed got gross, and I think I burned it, or I don't know where it is anymore. It's probably in the fiery pits of hell, but I haven't seen it in a while. I just remember that. I just remember doing that, and now I look back on it, it's completely disgusting, and I was a fucking idiot. But that's what you are when you're a teenager, you're an idiot. But hopefully you have good parents and you study hard in school and you don't become an adult and still call kids and want to masturbate with them, because that's not cool. But hopefully this episode was cool. Hopefully you guys enjoyed Awkward Situations. Remember to write your awkward situations in the comment and leave a like if you know what, you don't have to, but if you do, I'll pinch my nipples for everyone I get. So hopefully I'm gonna have some red bleeding nipples at the end of the day. This is just getting weird, and I don't know, I'm in a weird headspace. I'm tired, and my voice sounds at least 5 octaves deeper. So I hope you enjoyed that. Have a great day. Bye. All the fans love me, all the friends hate me. It could drive a sane man crazy, but I stay hungry, never get lazy.